Oh, hi! Wait a minute. Who are you? See those kids? They want to learn something about mixing today. One of the hardest parts of ditching errors is to know what to listen for. So let's listen for some. Input clipping. Signal that is being recorded too hot will clip your input. This might be desired with certain mic pre's to drive them into saturation, but never ever should the signal hit your converters too hard, which is meant when speaking about input clipping. Results sound like this. Note that input clipping can easily be spotted within the waveform even when it has been turned down. Output clipping. Digital or digitalized signal or, well, signal that is on your computer already will clip your output if it's turned up too much. Because of the way audio is handled by computers, there is a set maximum of possible amplitude for each waveform. If the waveform exceeds the maximum threshold, the signal is clipped and distortion artifacts occur. Results sound like this. Output clipping can easily be avoided by leaving about 8 to 10 dB of headroom on each channel or turning the master fader down. Latter one is dangerous though because it encourages the following. Improper gain staging. Not just the master fader is affected by digital clipping. Every fader on each channel is, so individual channels need to be checked for clipping as well and very carefully so, because they can basically clip within themselves without hitting zero on the channel output. How is that possible? Well, plugins, let me show you. Our signal is all fine. Now we put on an EQ and boost some areas. Those are now significantly louder. Let's put on some saturation and make it even louder. Now another instance of EQ with some more boosting. And to finish it off, Waves C4 because it features an input meter. Playing our channel back, we notice that the input of C4 is thoroughly clipping. Note that especially modeled analog plugins operate differently when hit with various levels of amplitude. Adjust accordingly. Phase cancellation. Sound is basically just a matter of plus and minus. If a minus hits an equal plus on a single frequency signal, both add up to zero and we have phase cancellation. Phase in this context is nothing more than a statement if the amplitude is a plus or a minus. Musical signal is usually complex and not a single frequency, so not everything adds up to zero. The result is the excess sound. COM-Filtering. COM-filtering is a side effect of partial phase cancellation. If two identical or very similar signals are delayed against each other, there are in-betweens until they are completely out of phase. On any of those in-betweens, regular intervals of the frequency spectrum get turned down while others get boosted. The result looks like a comb in a spectrum analyzer, thus the name, and sounds like this. Overcompression. A simple matter of abusing any compressor. Threshold too low, ratio too high, attack too fast, and release too slow. There's a heap of problems with overcompressing, such as choking notes, exaggerated noise floor, shitty mix. Some examples are... Compressor pumping. Another case of compressor abuse is compressor pumping. It's achieved with slower attack, at least audible but not too long release times, and a fair amount of gain reduction, that is, low threshold and at least 4:1 ratio for the beginners. The compressor works very audibly now and generates a distinctive pumping. Results sound like this. Note that the effect may be wanted when summing EDM or alike or on drum room channels. On single instruments, it's usually unwanted. Aliasing. This is confusing and very technical, so I'm gonna simplify it drastically. Depending on the sample rate you are working with, your DAW can handle a bigger or smaller chunk out of the frequency range. When working with 44.1, material over about 22 kHz can't be processed. It is possible, though, to introduce spectral content over 22 kHz by using basically any plugin, because almost all of them create harmonics to some extent. Those harmonics don't just disappear, unfortunately, but they are folded back in two and shattered all across the audible spectrum. It's easy to spot on a sign. Just listen to that ringing when I'm changing the key here. It's harder to spot on a complex signal, but I'm throwing one in for good measure. Note that this is the reason why you want to operate in at least 84 kHz sample rate. Aliasing is not a very huge deal from there upwards, but can be annoying when drowning your mix in effects. I linked a video by White Sea Studio in the description on why it still has to be handled with care. And that's that. Thanks for watching and take care.